In this episode, we look at the web of lies that Google has created, taking us out thinking they're not doing any VR, then bringing us back in through the back door of augmented reality. We're talking Logitech VR styluses so you can paint and tilt brush to your heart's content. And finally, we're going to talk about augmented reality in the real estate field. Do you want to buy your house from an augmented reality app? I don't know. Let's find out. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Actuality VR Show. This episode is brought to you by the Actuality VR VR Candle. Do you ever find yourself in a situation where the VR game you're playing isn't quite immersive enough? Introducing the Actuality VR Candle. It's perfect for all of your sensory needs. For those of you that are at AWE this week, super jealous. Please tell me everything that happens. But we're going to start a little different. So we're going to start again with Google. It's a common topic. They dictate everything. But what I do want to say is that with Google AI, we're going to start with Google AI. You're like, Kyle, what does Google AI have to do with VR? Well, it doesn't directly, but it does relate to the Google Jump platform being discontinued. Google published this article on their blog called Moving Camera, Moving People, a Deep Learning Approach to Depth Prediction. Now, this is, I know this is like way up here, so we're gonna try to bring it down. I'm gonna summarize that study for you. But essentially, what Google has found out how to do is take something like a photo. This time, just think of Facebook's 3D photo feature. So it's a normal photo that you take with your phone, and when you scroll down on your newsfeed, you get this kind of this pseudo 3D effect. That's essentially what Google is doing with video. So what Google is now able to do is take a normal 360 video and add depth to it. Just using AI, no additional hardware needed, nothing in the headset, nothing in the camera. This is strictly just from their code. So why is this important? Why are we talking about this specifically? Because I believe that when Google was working on the Jump platform, they were working on a technology that was applicable yesterday. Whereas when we start looking at volumetric capture, when we look at creating depth maps with regular video and creating these via AI, we're looking at the technology of tomorrow. And I think that's where Google's always been a tech forward company. They want to be one step ahead. They want to use especially their AI to create products. And this fits right up their alley. I think this makes sense for what they're doing. And I'm actually very excited because I believe this is that transitional step into volumetric capture. So it's a pseudo volumetric capture to where you, the viewer in a headset, can walk around a live action movie. Imagine being in the cockpit of the Millennium Falcon right between Han Solo and Chewbacca. That would be awesome. We want it, we need it, let's get it. So with the second story of the day, we're talking about the new Logitech VR Stylus. Yes, a VR stylus. So you've seen all the videos of people on tilt brush, but this has a very specific application. So Logitech specifically invented this because of the amount of white label apps that exist for enterprise. So when we talk about the way VR and mixed reality are being used at an enterprise capacity, what we're finding is that we now need new tools to create with them. So that when an engineer has an AutoCAD or a CAD drawing in front of them, if they have a 3D model in front of them, they can take this pen and they can wave it in the air in a 3D space in order to make adjustments and to draw and create new ideas in a 3D space while also being able to write on a typical pad. So you can use this stylus in a 3D space or on a normal tablet, something that you can draw on your desk and use as paper. So it's a really cool introduction. It's needed in the market. There's no specialized tools that exist for enterprise to be able to use at that capacity. So I'm excited to see where it goes. And for our last story of the day, we're gonna talk about a YouTube video that I came across. It was a really cool augmented reality application for real estate agents. So essentially in this demo, he shows us that projected into this backyard is a floor plan with a Matterport scan and information about the property. So imagine taking your cell phone up to a potential house that you are looking to buy, and you could scan the backyard, and floating in that backyard was a blueprint with all of these different photos and 3D scans. And I thought it was a really cool concept. There are a couple things that I would change design-wise, but I really do believe that he is trying to solve a problem, is that how do real estate agents best use this technology? And I've had a lot of those conversations with agents and brokers, trying to figure out how does immersive technology fit in a fast-paced and, let's be honest, affordable environment. Imagine the ability as a real estate agent to be able to show your potential client all of your properties in a virtual capacity, so that maybe you have your cell phone and you can project a 3D model of the house or a selection of all these different houses that you've used Matterport on. You have these 3D scans that you've paid for. Why not find a new way to use them and distribute them? So with augmented reality, we can place a 3D object on top of the table. But imagine looking at your table and seeing the model of a 3D house right here on your table, and you're able to swipe through and check out different floor plans. And when you find one that you like, you could put on your headset and then visit that location remotely. Put on your headset and literally walk through the house without ever having to leave your home or the realtor's office. And that will help you save time by narrowing down your options, because you've essentially walked through all these properties. You've narrowed them down to a select few. So if nothing else, a tool to redistribute content that you've already paid for. Now imagine you're a broker and you have a conference room. You can use this conference room as a presentation. You take your clients into this room and you project all your models onto your desk, and you're able to talk about them and look at them and point at them, and then select which one you want to look at and then put a headset on them. This is all portable. You don't need a computer. With the Oculus Quest now, that can fit in a simple desk drawer. You have the ability to teleport anyone, anywhere in the world, to your property immediately. That is the power of virtual reality. All right, guys, and finally, we're moving on to the 360 video of the day. The 360 video of the day is, it's a selfish plug, shameless plug, coming in with a hard right hook here, but it's a project that we did for Neverthirst, and we haven't released it to the public, so nobody's really seen this full piece. This is being used internally. So when I talk about nonprofits using 360 video to elicit empathy and to elicit donations, to be able to increase the connection between potential donors and existing donors to the people that they're affecting directly. How do we, in lieu of flying people halfway across the world to look at these conditions, why can't we directly recreate that environment in a virtual headset to where they are looking directly in the eyes of the people that they are affecting? And that's what we created for Neverthirst. So what we did is we traveled to Africa, we went to Chad and Uganda, and then we flew to Nepal where we filmed this two-part video showing what life looked like in a typical village in these countries. And it was when I was editing this video that I truly started to realize the impact of me as a creator, what my responsibility was, because in all actuality, this may be the only chance that this person, that this village, that these people have to get their voice out to the rest of the world for help. And knowing the full extent of that responsibility and going through and to be able to create this experience while also having the security and the confidence in knowing that the medium that they chose to create this experience is going to be their best shot at communicating that need.
Oh, thank you, my friend. You are really welcome here with us today for this blessing that God has granted to put us together and to put us in this field where hand in hand we walk together.
My friend, stand up!
We must do something for these people. This water. This water that runs in the village in peace. Have a drink with me. Oh, my friend, this water, clear like the source. And you take the water that runs. You take the water that runs.
They're a faith-based organization based out of Huntsville, Alabama. And they're still using the video internally, and they essentially, they have, that entire experience is in this headset. For $200, they are able to bring Africa to every single potential donor that they come in contact with. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by, checking out the show. You know, I really appreciate when you're here. I see all the comments, I see all the likes. And earlier this morning, I was looking back at some of the shows that we did last season, and I see the people that that watched last season that have continued to watch. I just wanna send a special thanks out because you're the guys that are still watching now. And I really appreciate that when you watch me ramble at the end of videos. I'm gonna go now. You should probably go do something too. So make sure to like us on Facebook, like the Actuality VR page, go ahead and subscribe on YouTube if that's something that you're into to get more of this. And this, I get to do something I love every day, and I'm so thankful for it. And I'm so thankful for you. So we'll see you next week, Friday, 3 p.m. See ya. No.
Yes.
No. 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 No.
No.
No. No. No. No.
No.
No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No. No